What's this? Oh, another one of these levels, okay. Oh. There's not a lot else I can say about this game. Like, all things considered, it's really a basic platformer in design. It's just the way they do it. They go about making the basic platformer that makes it interesting. Like I said, every level is... I didn't expect one to show up there. But the way they go about it in this game is unique compared to any other old just regular platformer, like they have the animal bodies, like, and just making them feel actually worth something. Like when you find an animal body, it actually feels like you again found a friend or just found someone to accompany you. And I don't know, just I need to stop rushing. But yeah, it just, and also the fact that every level kind of introduces a new obstacle in a way, or like a new enemy or something. Even if it is a recolor, they perform differently, or they do something different. So, alright, what's this? Ah, okay, another one of these. Fail, again. Buddy. Ah, man. Right in the eye. What the hell? Okay, After 10 million years, we finally did it. Also, we might as well go here, because never went to Candy before. But yeah, Candy. Basically, just save. So yeah, 49% apparently, so always good. Poison Pond. And now we see how... Yeah, just look at this, like, how messed up the water is here. Like, it's not even... I don't even know if you can really call it water, to be honest. Like, that's how messed up this is. But yeah, it's like... All the pollution, oil, and all that, and wow. You've really gone and, like, just appear out of nowhere. Just like that. Okay. I see how it is. I do like how you just land on a little area, though. I don't know if there's any real point in switching, but whatever. But yeah, the main obstacle in this level, I believe, is gonna be these will things and the squidges. There's fish every now and then, but it's not exactly the main threat here. Yeah, mainly it's just the wills. Still, though. Still a force to be reckoned with. Okay. Oh gosh. Ah! Don't do that. Alright, screw it. I'm not even gonna try. Halfway. Come on. There's only one checkpoint in every level, so can't be too far off. Actually, no. Well, there's obviously a lot more to go with this level, but still. I'm getting there. Oh gosh. Really? Man. No, what the hell? Okay, sorry about staying quiet there, but I was messing up way too much. I always be inside. Minecart Madness. Okay, finally get another one of these. And this... and this one you actually have to play. But this time, you can actually jump out of the... out of the minecart. I don't know why they decide to randomly jump out of them, but... hey, whatever. How can a minecart jump in the first place? That's what I want to know. In the first stage. No, I'm... oh, okay. I'm fine. Most of the time... wait, what? I was gonna say most of the time you want to hold forward when you jump, but... apparently not. Don't care. I just want to live. So far, actually, this is honestly easier than the other one. Which is weird. Yeah, now I can kill you. Oh, how the hell did we survive that? Okay. Not gonna complain. Oh! Yeah, that was a lot easier. Wow. Huh. Whatever. Blackout basement. Oh no, not this. So basically, the gimmick of this level is that it's the same as the first level of this world, except for the fact that every 2 seconds, if even that, the lights go off. So you basically have to just walk every 2 inches. Even the enemies go dark and you can't see, or no items or anything. You just have to go step by step. You don't want to take too many chances. Okay. You don't want to take too many chances around here, so you want to try and be careful what you, where you go. Because unless you have it level design memorized down, like, exactly, you want to try and be careful. Okay. Ooh. Ah, yeah, see, like that, that's annoying as hell. Yo. Okay, what's going on now? All right. All right, I'm just trying to concentrate, so sorry for all the quietness. Okay, oh. Oh, this is gonna be ugly. Oh boy! Is there something down there? Cool. It's so dark even in the bonus room. Can we get one, just one life, please? Alright, cool. Well, let's just get out of here. Oh, please, why do you have to have this guy? Oh, okay. Nice. There we go. That wasn't so bad. And now we have a literal oil drum. Or whatever. And this is basically just an enemy gauntlet. It's a cool... It's a unique idea for a boss. Well, not exactly with the enemy gauntlet idea, but like... The fact that we're just fighting an oil drum is kind of interesting. But the actual concept of the boss... Yeah, nah, not the most exciting, but still. Enemies go down in one hit, so it's not really an issue. But yeah, it's one of the easier... Funnily enough, like, how it's like one of the last bosses, honestly not that hard. It's, the guys that came before were honestly harder. Yep, he's done. Well, more specifically the last two bosses that we fought. He's obviously harder than the first boss. Oh, okay. Okay, so this is the last world. Now we can keep going. We're almost there.